Ladies and gentlemen, this is Ballet Ring. So if you've been on the internet at all these days, I'm sure you've heard the phrase very demure and very mindful. These words went absolutely viral not too long ago, and so now everybody's saying very demure, very mindful, and everybody wants to be very demure and very mindful. As it happens, ballet had its fair share of very demure and very mindful ballet characters. And so today, Jordan and I are here to conduct a very certified, very official, very scientific analysis on a bunch of different ballet characters and exactly where they fall on this graph. As you can see, we have our demure axis and our mindful axis. And what we're gonna do is go through a bunch of famous ballet characters and place them on a graph in accordance to their amount of demure and their amount of mindful. So if you're feeling very demure and very mindful and ready for the video, then make sure you tap the like button and let us be off.
Let's go.
Also, as a fun challenge, see if you can count how many times we say demure and mindful in this video. We've said it at least like 10 times already. If you can count every time we say demure or mindful in the video,
tally them up in the comments.
Drop it below. I'm actually very interested to see. So before we get started, we have to lay out our parameters. What defines a character as demure
and what defines a character as mindful?
Right. Obviously, we're gonna run to the dictionary real quick. So starting with demure.
Demure is characterized by shyness and modesty, reserved.
Ah.
Or affectedly or coyly decorous, sober or sedate.
So in essence, a character who is demure would be, you know, a little bit shyer.
Yeah, not flashy.
Yeah. And almost purposely so. Like they're intentionally
poised, yeah. Very put together, very proper.
I'd say proper. Yeah.
So that's demure, and I think we can all think of, you know, a handful of characters that would fit this quality. But let's move on to the definition of mindful. To be attentive, aware, or careful, noting or relating to the psychological technique of mindfulness.
So basically, obviously, being aware, being like mentally present, and like aware of your surroundings. So I feel like it almost has the implication of being considerate.
Mindfulness can be applied in many different areas.
Yeah.
You can be very self-aware. For one, you can also be aware of like other people, your surroundings, the scenario that you're in, you know. Like the definition says, like careful.
Like any degree of awareness.
Aware. Mindfulness will also be like not just what's happening now, but being able to understand possible consequences
of
your present actions. So I think that's a good criteria to base our ballet characters off of in terms of mindfulness. So without further ado,
let us go.
Let us go. We're ready to go. We have the graph here, as you can see. And we also have our ballet characters. You can't see them, but they're here. You want to draw first?
Sure. Let's draw this one. First character of the day is Giselle.
I think Giselle's pretty demure, actually. I think she's extremely demure.
Yeah. Almost peak demure.
I'd say so.
You know, I really do think she's like peak demure. If you watch that whole like bench scene where she's like,
she has this very, she's like, very shy.
But like conscientious of being proper and polite. She doesn't want to be too forward, I guess, with her relationship with Albrecht. Yeah. She's very reserved.
Yeah, she's very reserved, and especially with her interactions with the Countess as well, and like the royalty. She's very humble.
Yeah.
And very, you know, respectful.
Yeah.
So in terms of demureness, I feel like Giselle is like queen.
Up here somewhere.
She's up here. What a great start.
In terms of mindfulness though, where would I place her?
You know what? I don't think she's particularly mindful. She's not mindful of her heart condition.
Ah, yes.
For one thing.
Yes.
And then, I mean, Albrecht did do a pretty good job of hiding his red flagness, but like, she didn't pick up on any red flags.
That's true.
Until it was too late.
She's pretty like around here somewhere?
Yeah, kind of mid. We'll put her there. We can, of course, move these around just in ratio and in proportion to each other. Anyways, Giselle, our first candidate.
Very demure.
Very demure.
But not incredibly mindful. Moving forward.
Ooh.
Romeo.
Romeo.
I feel like he's actually pretty demure.
I say so too. I think he's very demure.
He's not like, Tybalt. Like, he's a bit like hot-headed, you know?
Yeah.
Like, Romeo's, he's a lover boy. Like, he's, you know, he's a little more gentle. He's a little more gentle, a little more.
Yeah, kind of mid-demure in terms of the demureness. But how mindful do you think he is?
I don't think he's very mindful at all.
I don't think he's very mindful either. Like, did we ever think about this?
He's pretty impulsive.
Would you put him more mindful than Giselle or less mindful than Giselle? I mean, they both died, so maybe they're equal.
I think they're pretty equal.
Well, I feel like hers was fairly innocent. Just I feel like he just made more mistakes. I'm sorry. I just feel like
Romeo, we can put him a little less mindful.
Just like nudge him. Oh, just that much.
He's pretty demure.
He's pretty demure.
But not very mindful.
Not very mindful. I'm cringing so bad right now, you guys. Let's keep going.
Ooh, okay. We have Medora, everyone's favorite pirate princess.
Medora, I say she's actually fairly demure.
Not Giselle demure. Like,
I feel like
in the middle, somewhat elevated. Dancers, if you know, you
yeah,
know.
Yeah, there we go. I would consider her fairly demure. Like, she's still a lady, but she's a girl who was put into a pretty bad scenario.
Yeah.
So obviously she is strong. She's able to defend herself and those that
take
she cares
a stand
about.
When she needs.
Exactly. But would I say she's outrightly
like flashy or
very showy?
I don't think
she is. I think she's still a lady at heart. You know?
I think I'd put her like here. I'd put her on par with Romeo, I think.
Yeah. This seems about right.
In terms of mindfulness, I'd actually think
she's pretty mindful.
She's pretty mindful.
She's more mindful than not, but she's not like exceptionally mindful.
The only reason we're putting her here is because she had the presence of mind to
stab
Burbanto when he attacked them.
Yeah.
So that's the only reason we're putting her.
But a little more mindful.
Because she had enough, you know, awareness, guts, presence of mind to stab when it counted, you know?
Exactly.
There we go.
Our girl boss, Medora.
Pretty demure and pretty mindful.
Yes! We have Princess Aurora.
Princess Aurora.
Princess Aurora.
We love her.
I think Aurora, I mean, she's a princess, okay? Of course she's gonna be like at the top of the demure spectrum.
Yep.
From the beginning of the ballet all the way up until the end, the demureness is, it's a constant.
Yes.
So she's definitely very demure. Would I say she's mindful though? Actually not.
I wouldn't say so. I think she was not really aware of her own prophecy. Her own curse on her own life. But in her defense, she was a princess, right? So like—
Yeah, she's sheltered.
She was very sheltered. Everyone probably took care of her. The whole kingdom was aware so that she didn't have to be aware.
Whether or not that's her fault is like, you know—
Up to debate.
It's up to debate.
Yeah. It's subjective, you guys.
So demure, yes, very, but is she the most, is she more mindful than Giselle?
Yeah, she's more mindful than Giselle.
I'd say so, just by—
Yeah, you know what, I'll put her
just
there.
Just by a hair.
Yeah. So I think like, yeah, she's not very mindful, but it's justified, you know?
It is kind of justified.
Like, no one told her about the prophecy. Or one might assume that no one told her about the prophecy.
So anyway, Aurora will
peak demure, but not very mindful. Okay, we have... we have Odile, you guys.
Okay, here's the thing with Odile. Because the whole thing, her whole character is a play.
Yeah.
So it's actually very hard to judge her on whether or not she is actually demure. I feel like in terms of mindfulness, she's very mindful. Like, she knows how to sense the energy in the room, I feel like. And she knows exactly what she should do in order to make them feel a certain way.
Right, that's true.
And to get her desired output.
She's like quick on her feet. She's aware. That's true, she's pretty mindful.
She's very mindful. Demure.
I'll put her like there.
I want to say she's demure because she's like playing, but I think a lot of interpretation, she's also very flashy.
That's true. Coming into the ball like ba 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 ba, like
that's not demure.
That's not demure.
That's not demure.
We'll put her like, you know what? We'll put her here because Tchaikovsky said so.
Yeah.
With her entrance, Black Swan Coda as well. Like that's when her true colors come out.
Mm-hmm.
So like that's not demure. So maybe
that's
I might
demure.
Like
there we go.
Very,
very mindful.
Mindful, but not very demure.
Not very demure. Ooh, we have Franz from Capellia.
Definitely not mindful.
Not mindful. He cheated on his girl for a doll.
He flirts with the doll, doesn't know that it's a doll, breaks into Dr. Coppelius' workshop, and falls for his the sleeping potion, and falls asleep, and Swanhilda has to save him. So that's far from mindful as you
off the charts, not mindful.
It's funny to me, his logic, that he was like, you know what? There's this old man in town, and everyone's kind of scared of him. Everyone thinks he's out of his mind.
Yeah.
Let me go in. Oh, he's offering me something to drink. Let me not hesitate.
And then accept seconds.
Yeah, that's true.
Not mindful. How about demureness?
Nah.
Demure,
if he's gonna like outrightly flirt with another girl.
He's kind of a red flag, y'all. I'm just saying.
A little bit.
He's not mindful of his own safety for one, and he's also not mindful of, you know, Swanhilda's mental health and well-being.
And his like commitment to their relationship.
Yeah, he's not mindful of that in the slightest. He's just like just
here for
there
a good time.
To have a good time and like have fun.
Here for a good time, but not for a long time.
He almost died, y'all. Anyway.
Next, we have Oberon from the dream.
Our fairy king.
He's great.
He's awesome.
Okay.
In terms of demureness, I feel like for the most part, he's very demure.
Because he's a king.
Because he's a king and he kind of has that part. But then the other side of him, and you see it sometimes, we're talking about the Ashton version here.
Yeah.
But like, there's some moments where he's just like laughing and like being... He and Puck are just doing their thing. And he's also, I feel like, a little bit temperamental at times. You know. I feel like in terms of demureness, he's kind of mid around this middle area.
In terms of mindful, though.
I think he's sharp and like very present, and I feel like he's very on top of the situation.
He's like conniving almost.
But does he use it to the benefit of others all the time?
Is he considerate of others, though?
He's considerate of himself.
Yeah, exactly.
Much so, but like...
But mindful, I feel like nowadays, mindful has that implication of like a bit more zen.
He is a little bit of that in terms of like the music.
That's true. Yeah.
It's a little bit more of that like zen quality.
Yeah, like that pirouette to the... To the attitude.
Yeah, it's a little bit more on the mindful side, I say.
Yeah.
Partway demure.
Yeah.
And a little bit mindful.
A little bit.
Moving forward, we have Albrecht, Count Albrecht from Giselle. And this is another walking red flag right here, you guys. Everybody take note. There's no way he's mindful of his own actions and like their possible consequences or the people around him, and especially the ones he claims to love so much.
Right.
So I feel like in terms of mindfulness, I'd even say less than Franz. It will move him just over a little bit.
He's like off the charts, really.
Yeah, like this is, Albrecht is off the charts.
He belongs here.
Like way over, like here.
He belongs here,
like way over here, you guys. Like, he's not even on this chart. But is he demure? I say so.
I'm thinking about
his kind of mid. Like, ba ba bum ba bum ba bum ba bum ba bum.
Yeah, like,
that's not that demure. He's a little flashy. He's a bit of a character.
And also, like, if you think of the way he, like, approaches Giselle.
That's true. He's very forward.
One of their first meetings.
Yeah.
Like, it's a little too... It's too much.
Let me hold your hand. Let me touch your face. Like, what?
What?
Red flag, you guys. Anyways.
Our personal opinion.
Not that very demure, not mindful at all. But he's like, less mindful than Franz.
He's not like hyper. Yes. He's just not demure. And he's very much not mindful. If I could put him all the way off
the I'm like trying to see how far the magnet will hold before. Here we are.
Yeah.
The A and the L are half off.
Not at all demure.
And not at all mindful.
Not at all mindful.
Not at all mindful.
As we continue forward, we have Romeo's counterpart.
Juliet,
you guys.
I actually think she's quite demure. I think she has like that very shy, soft girl energy.
Yeah. She has a bit more youthfulness than Giselle or Aurora. So maybe on the scale of demure, I'd put her like here.
Age-appropriate demure.
Yeah, age-appropriate. You're right. Yeah. She's young. No, but the thing is, she does rebel against her parents.
That's true. That's
like, she's not like, let me stay quiet. Let me not say anything. Let me be respectful. So it's like there. I'll put her there.
How mindful is she? I'm so sorry, but like, she and Romeo did not think a lot of things through.
Yeah.
And like, a lot of it's like, just because they were young, didn't really know how to handle. And it was a really tough situation too, you know?
Yeah.
So like, it's not her fault, but at the same time, she was not the most mindful in this story. So.
We'll put her here with Romeo.
Yeah. This is why the tragedy happened the way it did, because
they were both
equally not mindful. I imagine like if she was more mindful than him, then maybe we would have had a different ending.
They would have at least balanced each other out.
Yeah.
I'll move her over this much because she is just a girl. But it's also because she did make attempts to fix the situation.
She did.
See,
anyways.
I think a lot of ballet characters, to have a good story, you can't be too mindful.
That's the thing. Let's keep going. I wonder if anyone will end up like in these two quadrants.
I'm
very curious to see. Let's keep going. Oh, Kitri, our little firecracker. Definitely not demure. I think Kitri is one of the most flashy characters that we have on the board right now. So not very demure. There's some scenes, of course, where she puts it on, but it's like it's very clear that it's a whole show. Definitely not demure. Is she mindful? I actually think she could be a little bit more mindful.
She's not like mindful.
That's true. She's not peaceful,
mindful.
Quiet, mindful. Maybe she's not that mindful.
And she's not very careful.
She's
pretty reckless.
Maybe she's over here.
But she's a lot of fun.
The thing is, I feel like she's aware of the consequences, but she's not afraid of them. She's not turned off by them, and she's not intimidated by the potential consequences
of
her
actions. But that's not mindful.
That's not mindful,
is
it?
So maybe we'll like scoot her that way a little. Yeah. Not at all demure, and not very mindful. Okay, Conrad
from Le Corsaire. I mean, he's a pirate, you guys, so of course we're gonna have to rank him on not very demure.
And also, like, if you just look at his music, his choreography, everything's very,
his
like...
character. It's very flashy, it's very like, showy.
Yeah. Yeah, it's bold, very bold, it's bright, it's energetic.
So it's not like a negative not demure. It's just like, it's just a different character trait. He's just a lot more of that bold, flashy energy. For which is captivating in a way.
It's fun, yeah.
Is he so mindful? Actually, I think he's quite mindful, but like not the most mindful.
Yeah,
like I'd say he's more mindful than Oberon. I feel like he's kind of like meant to be a hero, but like he had a few hiccups in this ballet.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, like he fell for the... flower. I mean, it was an earnest gift he accepted.
That's true, because it came from Medora.
You know what I feel like?
Was Medora mindful then? Maybe she's not mindful.
That's right. She accepted a flower.
Oh!
From a stranger.
Oh!
Again, it could have been innocent. It could have been completely
innocent.
Yeah,
but still, she
was obviously it was, but like... She's like in the middle, I feel like.
Like she has her moments, like when she's mindful, she's mindful. No, but I feel like Conrad is mindful.
He's much more mindful, I think.
And also he was considerate to the slave girls that he...
Yeah, he freed them.
He freed them.
Like I think he was also mindful of Medora and respectful of her wishes to let her friends go free.
That's true.
So I think he's quite mindful. And I feel like at the same time, like
he's a good leader.
He seems like he has a pretty level head for the most part.
Yeah, you never really see Conrad lose his temper.
He never loses his temper. If he does, it's in defense of...
Yeah, it's like to de-escalate a situation.
Yeah. Kind of green flag energy, actually.
A little bit.
A little
bit. He's a little reckless.
A little bit reckless, but he's a pirate.
For a pirate standard, he's pretty mindful.
Yeah. Okay, we'll leave him there. And Medora got shifted. A little less mindful, but we still got a happy ending between the two of them.
Exactly.
There we go. We have Titania, the queen of the fairies from the dream.
She's
not that mindful.
She fell for a donkey.
Yes, but that was under a spell.
It was spell-induced.
It was spell-induced. It wasn't her fault.
Darn it, Oberon, why'd you do that?
You know, I actually feel like she's maybe a little bit more mindful than him. Because yes, she wanted to keep the boy for herself, but at the end, she gives it to him.
That's true.
That's mindful.
That is very mindful.
And I feel like in general, she has a very like fairy-like, very ethereal, mindful, zen-ish quality. So maybe she goes over there.
I'm going for like here.
More demure than her, for sure.
Yeah.
Is she more demure than Juliet, though?
No.
I feel like she's less demure than
she's
Juliet.
She's less demure than Juliet. So like between Juliet and Medora.
There we go. Okay, that's perfect.
Like right there.
Very perfect right there. Okay, anyways.
She's very like orderly with her fairy attendants.
All right.
All right, that works. Pretty demure.
This works.
Pretty demure.
Pretty mindful.
Okay, we have Siegfried. Prince Siegfried from Swan Lake.
I think he's quite demure.
He really is.
Being a prince. Yes, he has like his internal turbulence that he goes through, but I think in general he does come across as a very demure character. I think in general he was kind of like raised to be kind of like that upcoming king, you know? He kind of brought up that way. When the queen comes in, he's usually like doubled as her escort as well, so he's very demure in that scenario.
Yeah.
And then with all the princesses.
Yeah.
Demure.
He knows how to act in public, basically.
Exactly.
He knows how to be on his best behavior.
Yeah. And mindful, I think he's actually... I know he made a mistake and, like, fell for Odile, but I think in general...
Was that spell-induced, though? It might have been.
I think it was spell-induced. But regardless, I feel like in general, when he's handling Odette, you know, he's very empathetic.
True. And he wants to do the right thing.
And yeah, he has a good heart. In general, I feel like he's more mindful.
I think he is pretty demure. Put him on par with, like...
Juliet?
I think they're both
for royalty.
For royalty, you know, and nobility.
Yeah.
Yeah,
he
is pretty demure, actually.
Is he more mindful than Conrad, though?
No.
I don't think so.
We'll put him here.
But is he more mindful than Titania? Should we move Titania down this way, then?
Move Titania this way, and Sigrid can be here.
Yeah, so they're, like, basically on par.
Yeah, okay. I think that makes sense. That fits.
I think that
fits.
Can work. I feel like he's a genuine person.
Yeah, exactly. He's, like, genuinely mindful. It's just they capitalize the whole story on his one downfall.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, in general, I feel like he's pretty demure and also pretty mindful.
Oh!
Ali!
Oh!
Okay, I'm just gonna say this right off the bat. Ali is the greenest green flag, the evergreen flag. Definitely is very demure. The humility.
Yeah.
The reverence, the respect, the honor that he shows to his master, Conrad. I mean, and maybe this is just because he's his slave, but the demureness is like through the roof.
Yeah. And like, if you look at the whole Grand Pas de Deux from La Corsair, he's always like respect, bowing. He's always like kneeling.
He doesn't want to be the center of attention.
Yeah.
He just wants to elevate and make the moment the best that it can be, and then step out of the way and be like, oh, it was him. He did it all, or she did it all.
That's like peak demure.
That's peak demure. In terms of mindfulness as well, top mindfulness, you guys.
That's true. The amount of times he saves both Conrad and Medora.
He's technically a secondary character, but the fact that we have a happy ending at the end is him. He's the reason.
Yeah, I think he earned the spot of
very demure and very mindful.
We have our first one. Because honestly, throughout the whole ballet, you don't ever see him make a mistake. He's always attentive, always aware of what's going on, able to help when he needs it, to defend when he needs to.
Green flag, Ali. Find yourself a friend like Ali.
Raising the standard for all of us ballet protagonists out there.
Next up.
Ooh!
Tsarevna
from the Firebird.
Another dream role of mine.
Yes.
Sure. Oh. Her music is so beautiful.
Do, do, do,
it's very wistful, do, I feel
do,
like.
Do, 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 do. Like, it's so good.
It's very wistful. I feel like in terms of demureness, she's very demure. Very shy, very quiet, very reserved, very proper. In terms of mindfulness, I mean, she's like very aware of her situation, I think.
Yeah.
And I think she's also very considerate of Ivan, the prince who wants to save her, but she's like, oh, Kashkai is coming, you better leave. Save yourself, because I can't.
She's aware, she can sense when Kashkai is coming, when his presence is nearby.
Yeah. And she also pleads for him when Ivan does get captured.
Yes, that's true.
You know, she does intercede on his behalf. So I feel like in that regard, she actually might be pretty demure and mindful.
Oh! Ah. She's definitely peak demure.
Yeah,
peak demure. Like peak mindful, but
for the amount of story that she's given, she's actually very demure and quite mindful as well. Oh, another red flag, you guys. Solor. Although it wasn't really his fault. In a lot of versions, it wasn't his fault.
Yeah.
But a lot of the times, it's like... Anyways, I'm not going to get upset now. In terms of mindfulness, he does get trapped in a very sticky situation. He's basically being forced to abandon his girl.
Yeah, to abandon Nikiya, whom he has sworn eternal love to.
Yeah, so in terms of like being true to his oaths and his promises, not very mindful.
And he's not mindful of like the consequences. I don't think he was aware that, you know, an oath over the sacred flame is like no laughing matter. He took it lightly. And he also took it lightly that how Nikiya would take it.
He seems a little bit selfish sometimes. He's just only caring about himself,
yeah.
His life, his future.
And like also he was unable to read the room. Clearly the woman that he swore eternal love to was there dancing at his engagement to Gamzatti, and he didn't stand up or say anything.
Even when she got bit by a snake, he's just kind of standing aloof in most productions
until she dies,
or not even, and sometimes he'll just like leave.
That's true. I think it's because he's almost too demure. That's my thinking,
but like in a bad way.
He's too concerned about not causing a scene, and he's not mindful enough to override his demureness. You know what I mean?
He's very demure, but this isn't like a positive demure. It's like,
too reserved.
To his detriment. He and Albrecht are both very not mindful.
Yeah. You know, okay, I think Solor is a little more mindful than Albrecht because Solor's decision was based on a lot of pressure.
That's true. Yeah, he did it for fun.
He did it for fun!
That's ridiculous. Yeah,
I could go on.
He's not as bad. Less than Franz or no?
No,
actually, was more than Franz.
More than Franz. Franz will
Franz did it for fun as well.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, so Solor's a little bit more mindful than these two.
Everyone over here is like all scrunched together.
Yeah, they're all scrunched up together. Solor is very demure, but like almost to a fault.
Yeah, to his own downfall.
And not very mindful.
Ooh. Odette,
the white swan.
Okay, just admire this picture of Lauren for a second.
Lauren Cuthbertson.
There it is. Please and thank you.
Odette, I feel like, okay, in terms of demureness, as demure as they come.
Really,
she
truly.
She is like that.
Very shy, reserved.
Shy, reserved. But I feel like that's just her natural character. I don't think she's not playing at all.
Yeah,
she's
it's like
in earnest, too. So in terms of demureness, through the roof.
Mindfulness. I'd almost put her right in the middle.
Yeah, kind of in the middle. Depending on if you have the prologue, sometimes she actually is not very mindful.
No, but sometimes she suspects him right away.
Yeah, she does, actually.
It's not like she didn't try to run away.
Yeah, she definitely tried.
I'll put her right here. I think that's a pretty good place to put her. Very, very, very demure.
Yes.
And a little bit mindful.
A little bit mindful as well. Next up, Nikiya. Quite demure. She still stabbed Gamzatti.
Yeah, she still like had fits of rage. Like,
but I think in general, even through that, she's quite demure. I think maybe it's the mindfulness, the lack of mindfulness. Because she was very impulsive.
That's true. She wasn't careful.
With the Brahmin. and with Gamzatti, and with the king later, right after the snake bite incident. Yeah. So she's quite demure, but she acts before she thinks.
Definitely more mindful than Juliet,
for sure.
Yeah, because Nikiya, her outbursts are in a way are justified.
What about demure? Is she more demure than Romeo or less?
More.
More demure than Romeo.
She's like right up there with Juliet, but like there. Everyone's all crowded in here. What's up? This is like the protagonist ratio. Very demure, but like...
But like not mindful. This makes you a protagonist. I'm gonna add that into our protagonist script next time. Yeah, so there we go. Nikiya, quite demure, but not very mindful.
We hope you guys are enjoying the video so far. We just wanted to interrupt the broadcast real quick to plug our Patreon channel. If you have been enjoying our content for a while now and you would like to join the absolutely amazing group of people that have been absolutely monumental in powering the channel and helping us to do what we do, then we will welcome you with open arms. To the Patreon! All the information will be in the description box. And of course, to all our patrons, we love you guys and we appreciate your support. Puck! Also from the dream. He is definitely not demure.
Yeah, Puck is definitely not demure and not at all mindful. But I do think he happens to be a secret third thing, which is cutesy.
Oh yeah, like we have an x-axis, a y-axis, and a z-axis for cutesy.
Yeah, we should have a cutesy one, but as we don't have one, we'll just have to pretend.
Objectively, he's not demure. Yeah.
He's not very mindful either, but he's cute.
Yeah. He made lots of mistakes. He messed up the whole ballet. Like, the reason why the whole mess happened was because of this guy right here.
Yeah.
You know?
But then he saves the ballet at the
end. Yeah, he made it right.
He made it right.
Because he may not be demure, he may not be mindful, but he was the secret third thing, which is cutesy.
Cutesy. So, there we go. Puck, a little guy. We love him so much. We love Puck. Myrtha.
Ooh.
Our man-killing ghost queen.
I'd put her top demure because she's a ghost. Like,
yeah.
She doesn't have feelings.
She's emotionless.
Yeah, she doesn't have feelings. She doesn't have, like, any personality.
So then, is she demure or no? Is she
That's true. Maybe she's like perfectly neutral.
What if she's neutral? Mindfulness, I think she's quite mindful. In terms of like serving her own conscience.
Yeah. I mean, obviously she kills men for her living.
Like. But there's no consequence to that for her.
That's true. Because for her,
she
that's her
feel
job.
Bad. That's her job. That's her life's, well, her afterlife's mission.
I forgot about that.
So it's hard to say whether or not she's actually demure and mindful because, like...
She's more of a creature. Like, she doesn't quite have personality.
I don't know, maybe she's, like, right in the middle then, because, like, I don't really have a spot for her.
That's true, because, like...
She's not particularly mindful because she's just doing what she does.
Yeah, that's true. Like, there's nothing of her for her to be mindful of. No. Like, she's in no danger. Mm-mm. She doesn't have to be aware of anything. Like, she just is. Maybe we'll put her right in the middle.
Maybe she just... Right there.
Because she's a ghost.
Nobody really knows who she is. We'll leave her there for now until we come up with some further thoughts, but
if we do change it, we'll like put it on the Patreon or something.
Yeah, exactly. Anyways, we actually can't draw a conclusion on Myrtha.
Inconclusive. We would love your thoughts on this.
Yeah.
Colas from La Fimo Garde!
Another cutesy.
You can't put a boy in a floral waistcoat and yellow tights
and a robin's egg blue jacket.
Yeah! And you can't tell him he's not cutesy.
That is 100% cutesy.
Yeah. Now, is he demure? He's polite and respectful, but not demure. Like, he's like just a good guy, but he's not like demure in terms of like, I'm aware of etiquette and manners and-
Interesting, I feel like, you know that first scene in the first act when he like encounters Lisa's mother for the first time? I think he acts very respectful, very demure, and he's very polite. He's like, good morning, hello, I would love to see Lise, is she home? And then like, he gets smacked up in the face with the cabbage.
I love that scene. It's my favorite scene. He's like, chucking cabbage.
That's funny. Anyways,
I really do think...
I think he's actually more demure than not.
Yeah. And the thing is, because he's determined to have a good relationship, to build a good relationship with Widow Simone. He's not like you know, forget you, I'll take Lise. And he's more like a, let's work this out, I want to make this work for everybody. You know, so I think that is pretty demure, and I'd also say that's quite mindful of him.
More than Siegfried?
Here. No, I feel like Colas isn't really, like, demure.
Yeah, less demure than Medora, for sure.
Yeah, I'd even say less demure than Oberon.
Oh, actually, yeah, you're right. He's not flashy, but he's playful. So we can put him, like, kind of...
Yeah, like here.
Midway down on less demure. But it's not, like, in a bad way. Yeah, it's just...
that youthful farm boy energy.
In short, he is
pretty mindful.
Pretty mindful, kind of demure, but also very cute.
Two heaping spoon the cutesy.
Yes, there we go. In my opinion.
We are approaching the end.
Swanhilda.
Oh!
From Capalia.
For sure not demure.
Demureness for Swanhilda, I feel like, I think she's definitely below the midline. Yeah, because she still has that spark.
Yeah.
She has that character and she wants to be the center of attention.
And she's sassy, she's showy.
Opinionated.
She wants like all eyes on her.
Yeah.
Popular girl type of energy.
She is a popular girl and we love that for her, but it's not demure. Yes, but it's not in a bad way, but it's like definitely gonna be below the midline.
Yeah. I would really say that Swanhilda and Kitri are like,
they're almost the same. Oh, and she and Franz, look at them. They line up perfectly in terms of the demureness.
She's just a little more mindful.
Just a little bit more mindful.
I think where we have her is fine.
Yeah, on par with Kitri, I feel like. Because they're honestly, their characters and the way that they present themselves is very similar. Like, they have a very similar energy. They're both popular girls in a small town. You know,
they're very
needy. Like, they crave attention.
Yeah.
And the reason why Kitri's a little bit less demure just because she's a little bit more
showy.
Okay! I feel like we're getting a little bit more evenly spaced.
A little
just
more.
A little bit. Yeah. We have a few left. Let's keep going.
Okay, oh!
Oh my.
Basilio, also from Don Q. Definitely not demure. Less demure than Kitri?
I feel like he's a little bit more mature than Kitri. Plays around with her a lot, but at the same time, I feel like he's a little bit more emotionally stable than Kitri is.
He's not as, like, volatile. Except for when he's playing. Like, when he was like, I'm so mad at you. I will die. Like, that was just
a play.
Yeah, but the thing is, I don't think that's very considerate. Yeah. Don't fake your death to marry your girlfriend.
Yeah, don't do that.
I don't feel like that was mindful.
Yeah, and like, that could have gone way wrong too.
Like maybe he's like, he's more demure than Kitri, but less mindful than Kitri. All our men are here, you guys.
Why are they here? We only have like a few here, and then they're like, boom,
boom.
Here. This seems to be like a very popular formulation for our male protagonists.
Oh, I was gonna say he's a bit mindful. But then I realized that he faked his death to trick
his intended father-in-law.
His intended father-in-law to give them the blessings. No, that's not mindful.
That's not very mindful. I mean, you're just lucky it's a libretto and we wrote it in your favor.
Yeah, exactly.
Don't try this at home, kids.
This could have gone way wrong. Please don't do this.
Next up, we have Lise from the Female Garde.
Ooh.
I think she's
a little bit demure.
A little bit demure.
I'd say on the line. Like, she knows enough to be polite.
Mostly because, like, if she doesn't act demurely, she gets spanked. So I feel like she is forced to be demure. She does have a playful spirit to her, though. So, not very demure, but she's still, you know, decently demure. She still tries to be proper. Mindfulness? I feel like she's not that mindful, but good fortune just kind of falls on her somehow.
Let's put her, like, there.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you see, like, she and Colas kind of balance each other out.
That's why we have a happy ending.
Because I feel like Colas was more considerate to Widow Simone.
Yeah.
She was like, forget you. Yeah. She would have run away, you know.
Yeah, she wanted to.
Colas is more like, hey, let's come and ask her one more time if we can, like, get married. He wants them to make amends.
I think so.
Yeah.
So Lise is moderately demure and moderately mindful, but also very cutesy.
Very, very much cutesy. We're on
the final three, let's go.
Ivan from the Firebird.
I love this whole ballet and his character, honestly.
Ivan's great.
So cool. Demureness, very demure.
Regal prince.
He has a very stoic sort of demeanor.
He's like an adventurer.
He's passionate, but he's not overly like emotionally driven, you know?
In terms of mindfulness, he's not at all.
Well,
okay, you know, he puts himself in the most unmindful situations. Like,
that's true.
He goes out searching for danger. See? Like, the reason why he's in that enchanted wood is just because no one else has made it out alive.
I think it's just the adventurer in him.
Exactly. He meets the garden with the golden apple tree and he goes, fantastic, I will take one. He meets an enchanted firebird, fantastic, I will take it. He meets the present, fantastic, I will take it.
In general, he's quite experienced in that realm, so given his skill set.
Because he knows he can take it.
Yeah, so I feel like if someone like Colas did that, that would be very not mindful.
It would be dumb, yeah.
I'd be like, why are you trying to purposefully die? But Ivan, I feel like being like that, you know, strong warrior prince that he is, I don't think it's okay. He can still be considered mindful.
That's true.
He leaves with a lot of trepidation.
Yeah, he's armed, he's ready. Yeah.
Siegfried also was a hunter, but I feel like Ivan was a little bit more experienced. Like, he's not just like a
recreational
hunter.
Sport. He's like out here fighting wizards.
Exactly. I also like would push him towards more mindful.
Oh yeah, he's pretty mindful.
He's very mindful.
Like he's experienced.
He's very experienced, and I think he's very smart.
He's smart, he's careful, he's alert.
Very alert. Also very considerate of princesses and all the other people who are turned to stone, you know.
Yeah, that's true. And like he becomes the king.
Yeah, he does.
Later.
You need to be mindful to be a king. Ivan is also another huge green, despite his clothes, he's very much a green flag.
Disregard the red.
Disregard
apparel.
The red, please. He's a green flag.
If he won't kill an immortal wizard for you, what is he even
doing? What is he doing?
No. If he wanted to, he would.
I'm sorry, All right, up next we have Princess Gamzatti from La Bayadere.
Is she demure? She's regal.
In terms of demureness, I feel like she's not as demure as some of the others on the board right now. Like, yes, she's very proper. Yes, she is that princess. She carries herself very regally, but she also wants to be in the limelight. She enjoys being the center of attention. She loves being adored and looked at and beheld in a very majestic light. So
that's true.
I feel like in that sense, less demure.
Like, if you hear her variation, you're like, da 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 da. But with like all the glisses and the harps it's a splashy.
It's very splashy.
Majestic piece.
Yeah, she's like, here I am, and she expects the applause because she knows it'll be there.
Yeah, exactly.
She is love.
Yeah. No, I'd put her right on the line. Like, she's demure because she's a princess, but at the same time, she is a bit showy.
Mindfulness, actually, I feel like she is quite mindful.
She is very mindful. Can we put her like
she's
here?
She's actually pretty mindfully.
Let's put her like here. They're right next to each other.
Yeah, they're right next to each other.
On the demure and mindful chart. No, because the thing is, she's very, very mindful.
Yeah.
It's just everyone, like, it's because she's the antagonist. Because in a way, I consider her the secondary female lead. Because both women are, like, the antagonist in the other person's story.
Exactly. It's only because we're seeing the ballet from Nikiya's perspective that we see Gamzatti as, like, the antagonist. But really, if you look at it from Gamzatti's perspective, like, the whole narrative shifts.
And she's actually very mindful in the ballet.
She's mindful enough to sense that something's up. Not quite right between her and Solor. And then has the nerve to go and eavesdrop on her father's conversation.
To figure out what's going on, sends it out, makes a plan, invites Nikiya to talk it out, offers her compensation, is like, I don't want this as much as you don't want this.
But can we make it
work
for both of us?
Yeah.
Well, I think she was also very mindful after the assassination attempt.
Like, logical response for anybody, especially someone like her, you know, she's a princess, right?
The kingdom's on her shoulders.
For her, in her perspective, the logical reasoning would be, we have to get rid of Nikiya.
Get rid of Nikiya.
You know?
She's a threat to the kingdom. Subjective debate. Should Gamzatti be considered the antagonist or not? Subjective. We think not. But anyways, we think that Gamzatti actually is quite demure.
Yeah.
And also very, very mindful.
Very extremely mindful.
Extremely mindful.
All right, final one.
Who's it gonna be?
Boom.
Our one and only Jemima Puddle Duck, and there's only one spot Jemima could be. Of course, she is very demure. I mean, she wears a little kerchief around her neck, okay? Yes. For being a duck, mindful.
By duck standards, she's very mindful. Mindful.
But at the end of the day, this graph is simply not good enough to contain our icon, Miss Jemima Puddle Duck.
The number one in my heart, the love of my life, and my dream role.
The only rightful place for Jemima is on this graph right here.
Where she will reside in 100% puddle and 100% duck.
The title of Puddle Duck is far beyond what demure and mindful could ever be. And so
we are honored to award Miss Jemima the place at the top of the chart. So there you have it, everybody. This is our completed chart of demure and mindful ballet characters.
We just noticed that there's actually a pretty strong diagonal from like this corner to this corner.
That's true.
Isn't that interesting?
And then there's like a huge spot.
Yeah, very concentrated area of very demure but not mindful characters.
Yeah.
I think we actually learned a lot about like patterns, I guess, and like what create certain kinds of stories and different kinds of protagonists.
Yeah. We're very curious to know how y'all would rate yourselves.
Yes.
On the very demure, very mindful graph.
Are you just below Titania or slightly to the right of Swanhilda? Let us know how demure and mindful you are. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like the video, of course, remember to like the video. Yeah. And make sure to share this video with your most demure and mindful friends.
And if you guys were keeping track of how many times we said demure and mindful throughout this video, please drop it in the comments below. And we'd be very, very interested to know the final total. Anyways, I think that is all from us for now. This is Ballet Rain signing off. Until the next video.
Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is...
That's so dumb.
That is so dumb.
Why are we doing
cringe.
This?
Cringe. Oh my God. Okay, we'll so do it. Cringy. We'll do it again. We'll do it again.
Not demure, nor mindful.
And exactly where they fall on this graph.
So stupid.
Okay, I need to keep focus. Focus, Eden. Focus, Eden. Oh yeah. Wait. You can do the.